Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to today's session on deep learning. Padmavati ma'am, I have given you the right so that we can start with the session.
Thank you, Sakshi. I will start the session soon. Is my screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Let's start with today's session on deep learning. Till now, we discussed with convolutional neural network, and we have seen the detailed block diagram of the convolutional neural network. What are the basic building blocks of convolutional neural network we have seen, right? Just to revise, we do have different types of layers in convolutional neural network, like input layer, right? And convolutional layer, where we do take the kernel and we do perform the convolutions by striding the kernel over the entire image from left to right and top to bottom, right? And we do have pooling layer, and pooling layer we can have max pool as well as average pool, okay? But most usually we do go for max pooling, right? And apart from that, we do have fully connected layers, right? Those fully connected layers we do require at the end, right? So why we do require at the end? Because at the end, suppose if I want to perform some sort of classification and I want to classify into two classes, then at the end I don't require n number of classes. I do just require two number of classes. So whatever my output image before fully connected layer has, so it is in the form of matrix, or it is in the form of higher dimension. So that higher dimension need to be reduced to your single vector. Okay. So that once we reduce that higher dimension to single vector, whatever is the size of that particular vector, and I will introduce one more fully connected layer just to make sure that I do get at the end, at the output layer, I do get two types of outputs, right? Two outputs, basically. Just to differentiate that, my model is going to give classification for two different classes, right? So like this, we do have convolutional pooling layer and fully connected layer. Usually in any of the given architecture, what we have is, we do have set of convolutional layer and pooling layers. They can be one convolution and afterwards pooling layer, one pooling layer, second convolutional, second pooling, third convolutional and third pooling. And nowhere it is mentioned that we need to take in this fashion. In some of the architectures, there are some standard architectures which have been defined by researchers since many years. Right, we will see some of the important architectures maybe from next class onwards, and we can see in those different architectures different types of these kind of layers are stacked on one on the other, right? Like some architecture may take convolutional layer, pooling layer, and next convolution, pooling, and so on. Like they do stack convolutional layer, pooling layer together, and one convolution, one pooling, and later on again one convolutional they will perform and one pooling, and so on. Like this, they can have n number of convolutional and pooling layers, and at the end they will have set of 2 to 3 fully connected layers. But it is not defined that we need to use the we need to have if I want to define my own architecture for the given problem, then we are free to do that. I nowhere define that I should have convolutional and afterwards pooling, convolutional and afterwards. No, we can have two convolutional layer and later on pooling layer. That is also possible, right? Now, if we want to perform some sort of before dealing with architectures or standard architecture, what type of architectures have been defined by researchers. Before seeing that, we need to see how many number of parameters which required to learn in convolutional layer. Okay, that we will discuss in today's class. With that, let us try to revise whatever we have done in previous session. How do we compute the output image volume given the input image? Suppose input image has 28x28x1 dimension, and my kernel has 3x3x1 dimension. Here depth of my kernel will always remain equal to depth of my input image. Here input image is single dimension, 1D dimensional, right? 1D depth. So my kernel will also have 1, right? Depth as 1. If I take RGB image, then we will be having 3 channels, that is depth is 3. So my kernel will also have depth as 3, right? So with this input image, 28x28, with this kernel, that is 3x3, we will be, if we perform this convolution operation by performing that convolutions on this particular input, when we perform from left to right and top to bottom, then each this particular convolution will produce a single pixel, and that pixel will be placed at this particular first row, first column, that is first cell. I will place the resultant of my convolution at the first pixel. Okay, very next pixel, I will perform the next convolution and I will place the next pixel value, and so on. Like this, I will perform the convolution and I will prepare my output image, right? So size of output image should be 28 minus of 3. Here I have not explained, or I have not given values of stride and padding. So it can be assumed, if not given, it can be assumed size as a stride as 1 and padding as 0. That means no padding. We are not performing any kind of padding on this particular given input image. Correct. So when I perform convolution on this particular input image, then what is the size that I'm getting? I'm getting 26, 26, height as 26, width as 26. How? Using the same formula, that is 28 minus 3 minus 2p, that is p here is 0. So minus 0 divided by 1 plus 1. It comes out to be 26. Suppose number of filters like this, I will perform 1 and I will prepare this. What I'm getting is, I'm getting 1 activation map for the corresponding input image. Like this, I will have different filters. I will take different filters, n number of filters if I take, then I will have n number of feature maps. Okay, this is what we have discussed in the previous class. If I take first kernel and I convolve it over the entire image, my resultant image will be 1 feature map. If I take second kernel and if I perform convolution on this particular image, then I will get next feature map. So like this. In this example, I am going to perform 4 convolution operation with 4 different filters. Then I should get 4 different feature map like this, right? So this is my input image. This whole thing is my output image, correct? So what is the height? Height and width we have computed using that W1 minus H1. W1, that is width of the image minus width of the kernel minus 2 into P divided by S plus 1. Okay, that gives me 26. Similarly, height will also be computed with the same formula as we discussed in the previous case. What about the depth? Here depth is equals to always equals to number of filters that we are using for the convolution. So if I am using 4 filters, my output depth will have 4. Correct. Similarly, if I have n number of if I apply n number of different filters on the given image, then my output depth will be n. Okay. So after doing this revision, let us this forms my convolutional layer, right? Result of convolutional layer 1. This forms the result of convolutional layer 1. Let us just try to revise what is max pooling. Given the input image, okay, what I will be doing is I will be applying max pool on this given image with a stride rate as 2. When I take stride rate as 2, then my output is going to reduce. It to what extent? It will be reduced to half, right? So initially it was 4 cross 4, so it will reduce now to 2 cross 2. How do I compute? First pixel, I will take 2 cross 2 and I will see which one is having, which cell has maximum pixel value. I will pick that and I will place in the first cell. Okay. Similarly, next trick, I will compute max pool on these 2 cross 2 pixels and whichever value is maximum, I will simply place here. 11 is maximum, so better you place 11. Right. So next is 2 cross 2 on this. Why have we are moving after this? Why I'm moving on this particular block? Because it should be clear by this stride rate as 2. If stride rate is 1, then after performing max pool on this particular block, I could have moved on this particular block. Correct? But here stride rate is 2, then I need to leave 2 cells and I will be moving to the next 2 cross 2. Right? So again, after 2 rows, I will pick and I will check these 2 cross 2 and whichever has maximum, I will take that. Okay, this is the resultant of max pool operation. Similarly, I will apply max pool on these 4 and yes, this is the result. Correct? Now, let us try to understand output volume and number of parameters for set of given examples. Okay. Let us take the example as image. Here, blue color is indicating the input image. Okay. Here is the input image. And input image dimension is 28 cross 28. And we have kernel size as 3 cross 3. And when I apply, we know that I will be getting the output volume, okay? And we know how do I compute height of output volume, output image and width of output image. And here number of filters are 32. Then it is very much clear that we need to have 32 different filters on this particular image and I will be getting 32 different feature maps. Okay, and those that 32 feature maps that I'm getting, so what I will be getting, that itself will become the depth of my output image. Okay, kernel size remains as 3 cross 3. So you know, this is what we have discussed just now, number of filters. When we take 4, then 4 different feature maps will be generated, but here number of filters are 32. So 32 different features maps will be generated when we apply 32 filters over the image, right? Now, number of kernels filters are the same, that is 32. Then how do I compute the number of output volume? Output volume, just now in the previous slide, we have computed. And the only change is instead of 4 filters, here we do have 26 cross 26 cross 32 different 32 filters we have applied. So we got 32 different feature maps. Hence, my output image will have 32 as my depth. Okay. Now, let us try to understand how do I compute number of parameters. Number of parameters will be computed based on this equation. Okay, here number of parameters are nothing but what I need to what we are doing in convolutional layer. We are performing sort of convolutional operation. Okay, so what is the what should be the image or what should be the pixel values of these kernels, or indirectly what are the weights which should be assigned to this particular kernels. Okay, so it should be ideally I will start with some random numbers. I will initialize this 3x3 filter with some random numbers, and later on I will through a forward propagation with the help of that random number perform convolution pooling and fully connected layer, and later on I will get the output. If I will check the output at the output layer, I will check the error. Once we get the error, we will see the quantity of error. If the error is too high, then I need to back propagate it. If the error is too high, which is not acceptable, then what we need to do is we need to back propagate that particular error with the help of back propagation algorithm from output layer back to the back till the like convolutional layer, till we reach all the layers. Okay, so in order to do that, what we need to do is what are we trying to learn. We are trying to learn the exact weight. What should be the exact weights of the kernels? Okay, so that my output should always give me correct output without any loss. Fine. So ultimately, in forward propagation, I'm keeping the values of these kernels randomly. I will keep, and I will try to perform some sort of convolution pooling and so on. All the computations, I will get the output. At the output image, I will check the error. If error is high, I will back propagate that particular error back towards the inside the network. Okay, and ultimately, in each layer, we will be performing some sort of convolution operation at the convolutional layer. So when we back propagate, what it will do is it will try to adjust the weight such that my error should be low in the next step, right? So here number of parameters are nothing but how many number of parameters which are required to perform for the network, right? So for example, here number of parameters we have computed with the help of 3x3x1. Okay, one here is depth of my kernel. I already informed depth of my kernel will be same as depth of input image. So depth of the kernel is 1. So 3x3x1 plus 1. Why this 1 plus 1? Because for this particular kernel, I will be adding bias, right? So 3x3x1 plus 1 into 32. Why do I add 32? It should be clear because we need to, these are the parameter values of my kernel. Okay. Plus, and I need to have such kernels, so many number of parameters of this particular kernel. This is the number of parameters for one kernel. This is the number of parameters for one kernel. But how many kernels that I'm using to get this convolutional layer or to get this output? I am going to apply 32 different kernels, right? So I will multiply that 32. So I will be getting 320. So total number of parameters are 320, which are need to be learned through back propagation algorithm. Let us see one more example. Here we have 32x32 as my input image, and kernel size is 5x5. And you know, when we apply the kernel or this particular convolution operation of using this particular kernel or input image, I'm going to get 28x28, and depth will always depends on my number of kernels. right? So once we get 28 cross 28, when we apply six different filters, I'm going to get six different feature maps. So now the resultant depth of this particular image will be six, right? Now output volume will have 28 cross 28 cross six. This six is result of the number of kernels that we are applying. Okay, next, number of parameters which are required to learn. How many parameters? As I said in the previous case, in this previous example, it is size of the kernel 3 cross 3 cross 1 plus 1 bias multiplied by number of total number of kernels that we are applying. In a similar way, in this also, what we will be doing is we will be applying 5 cross 5 cross 1 plus 1 multiplied by 6. It comes out to be 156. So total number of parameters that need to be learned for this is, for this example, you can say it is some, it is the example like resultant of a number of parameters. These number of parameters need to be learned, right? So this is how we do compute number of parameters. It depends on size of the kernel. Size of the kernel plus volume of the number of filters. Okay, this is very interesting. When I apply this I discussed in the first class itself, why should I go for convolutional neural network? Why not fully feed forward neural network? Okay, because of this difference. For the same example, okay, 32 cross 32 cross 1, for the same given input image, when I apply convolution operation on if I take six different filters and I apply convolution operation, then we just computed, it comes out to be 156, right? Now, when I take fully feed forward neural network, then wait a minute. When we take fully feed forward neural network, so my input image is 32 cross 32, correct? Which comes out to be 1024. So you do remember how we used to have, how many number of neurons we used to have? We used to have these many neurons. That is 32 cross 32 in the input. This is my input layer. Fine. So this is 32 cross 32, which comes out to be this. Fine. These many inputs we used to feed to the hidden layers. How many hidden layers? How many hidden layers in this? We need 28 cross 28. So these many. Okay. So it comes out to be 784. So 1024, we know each, this is my input layer, this is my hidden layer, this is my hidden layer, and we know the hidden layer, the connections are very dense. This is my weight matrix. Okay. And each neuron is connected with every other neuron of the previous layer and to the next layer, we know it, right? So many connections we are performing, that means this is the weight matrix of each of these connections. Plus, we will also have how many? We will also have 784 different biases. Correct? So it comes out to be 1024 multiplied by 784 plus from bias also we give bias values to each of these neurons. So this 784 is from that. Okay, these many values that we need to compute, right? Multiplied by 6 because we are going to apply 6 different filters, right? So this is the difference between number of parameters when you compute feed forward neural network is much higher than number of parameters which require to learn is very, very less in convolutional operation. You can check the number, you can cross check the number. It is very small value as compared to this. This is the resultant of the previous layer. Now, this is a resultant of convolutional layer 1, and I take that convolution layer 1 result and I give this as an input to my next operation. Okay, so let us try to apply max pooling layer with a stride rate as 1. So it comes out to be, if I take input as 28 cross 6 and number of filters are 6, and here number of filters are nothing but the same as my depth of my input, right? And 2 cross 2 is, I will take every 2 cross 2 and I will take the maximum value and I will move forward, right? So whenever we perform this, my output volume, it will reduce to 14 cross 14 cross 6. Why 14 cross 14 cross 6? Why this 6? This 6 is required because here we are not performing max pooling with respect to depth. Here I will take each feature map of my input image and I will perform the max pooling, and it will result me one output image, okay, one output. And later on I will take the second feature map and again I perform the max pooling on this second feature map, and again it will result me the next one, and again like this. So with respect to each So here max pooling is performed based on this. I will take first input. Okay, and I will take this max pooling on this cell and I will move forward. And I will take maximum pooling on this cell and I will move forward and so on. With each result, I will put in my output like this. For this particular activation or feature map of my input, I get one max pool output. Similarly, I will take the second one. I will get the next output feature map. I will take the third. I will apply max pooling on this particular third input activation map and I will get this is my resultant of my max pool on the third input activation. And similarly fourth I will take, it will result me fourth, like this. So on each of these activations I will perform max pooling, and these are the different resultant of my max pool operations, right? Okay, one very interesting thing is number of parameters which require now is 0. Why number of parameters which are required now is 0? Because we are not going to perform any sort of convolutions. Okay, we are not using any kind of filters, right? And any kind of that convolution operation here. What I am doing is I am taking two, every 2x2 image, input image, and I'm computing what is the maximum value, and I'm putting over here. And again, on the next, very next block, I'm computing, and I'm again putting, and I'm again computing the maximum of on that particular cell, and I'm going to get the next matrix value, next pixel value, and so on. So here, number of parameters which require for max pooling layer is zero. This we all should understand, right? This you just ignore the last statement. That is not. I just wanted to illustrate with respect to first convolution operation only, right? Before that, output volume on this max pooling layer is 14 × 14 × 6. It remains 6 because we are applying max pooling on each of these individual activation maps of my input. So it results me 6 different activation maps. That means depth of my output after applying max pooling is 6. I will take that result of my max pool, first max pooling operation, that will become input for the next layer, that is 14 × 14 × 6. I will take as an input, and I will try to apply convolution layer with a stride rate as 1. This is my input for my convolution layer. Okay, number of filters that I apply this time is 16. Size of each filter that I'm going to apply is 5 × 5 with a padding as 0. So output volume is, we know, very simple. This 14 − 5 + −2 × P divided by stride as 1 + 1. It comes out to be 10 × 10 × 16. Why 16? Because number of filters which we have considered are 16, right? Now someone compute number of parameters which require for this convolutional layer 2. After applying that convolution operation on this given input image. Image, send in a chat box, or yes, better send me in a chat box. How many parameters required to be learned? Am I audible? Volume should be clear to you by this time. How do I compute the volume? 14 − 5 comes out to be 9. −2p, p here is 0. No padding for on this particular input image is performed. And divided by stride rate as 1. Hence, it comes out to be 10 × 10 × 16. Right? Now, I just want to compute how many parameters which require to learn. So, okay, let me consider. This is my input image. Let's take different example, and I will make you do compute by yourself for that example, previous example. I do have 10 × 10 as my input image, and I am going to apply convolution operation with this kernel 3 × 3. Okay. Now, I do have two such kernels with the same size, 3x3 size. When you apply on this input image, okay, think that we do have 10 different columns and 10 different rows. Okay, 10 different rows. Now I will take the first kernel, let me call it as k1, kernel 1, and I will perform convolution operation on this particular given input image. When we perform convolution operation on this particular given input image, we are going to get the output image. What is the height and width of that output image? It should be, we have already discussed, let's consider stride rate as 1 and padding as 0. With this information, I can easily compute that W. I can easily compute width of my output. Here width W2 indicates width of my output image, and W1 is indicating width of my input. W1 minus kernel width plus minus 2 into P divided by S plus 1. This is what we have discussed already. Similarly, H2 height will be equals to H2 minus height of my kernel minus 2P divided by S plus 1. It comes out to be 10 minus 3, right? So 7 minus 2P 0 divided by 1. So it comes out to be 7. 7 plus 1, it comes out to be 8. So my output image will have, even height will be 8. Okay, you may compute by yourself. We are considering the square values, right? So 8 cross 8. This is my output image, correct? This is actually activation map or feature map of after applying for K1, after applying first kernel. In a similar way, when I apply second kernel with the same size, I am going to get one more output. Let me call this as an, again, you may compute height and width of this feature map. It comes out to be same, that is 8 cross 8. So we do have two different feature maps. First feature map of 8 cross 8, second feature map of 8 cross 8. Now what I will do is, this is my output. This is my output. Okay. Now I for this given input, it is going to generate this output, but number of parameters which required to learn are, how many parameters we do require? We know it should be kernel size 3x3x1. Okay, depth of this kernel is same as depth of this particular input image. Depth of input image is 1, hence it is 1.
Excuse me.
Plus 1, I will add to my bias. I will take your queries at the end. After this, what I will be doing is, I will be simply multiplying by number of kernels. Here, number of kernels are 2. Okay. So for this given input image, okay, with all these parameters, we call these as an hyperparameters again. With these hyperparameters, I'm going to get number of parameters that need to be learned for this particular operation is 3x3x1 plus 1 multiplied by 2. You can compute in total what is the result. In a similar way, I asked you to compute this. number of parameters to which are required to compute. I myself showed you. Okay, it is like size of the input image, that is 5x5. Depth of my kernel will be same as depth of my depth of this input. It is 6+1 multiplied by total number of kernels that I am going to apply. Here for this particular example, I am going to apply 16 different kernels. Hence, number of parameters which required to learn are 2416. Right. Now let us look at some architecture, and we at the end what we need to do is we do have different layers associated with this particular architecture, and with each in this architecture we do have again set of convolutional pooling layer and fully connected layer, right? So let's try to understand after every layer what is the resultant output volume and what are the how many parameters that are required to learn. We do have input image 28x28x1. Number of filters are 64. Kernel size is 3x3 and stride rate is 1. Try to compute the output image as well as number of parameters for convolutional layer 1. First, perform this convolutional layer. Okay. Depth, volume. I asked output volume. 26x26x. Depth will be 64. Yes, correct. So let's move on. Number of parameters. You also compute number of parameters. Okay. 3x3x1+1. Okay. The second option is correct. Whoever has answered it correct, it is correct. So it comes out to be, we know it is size of the kernel, that is 3x3x1 plus 1 bias multiplied by 64. Right. So output volume here. Okay. Compute it for 32. Compute it for 32 as well. Instead of 64, compute it for 32. I might have computed it for 32. Okay. Okay. So number of parameters are these. Correct. Now, with kernel size as 3x3, stride rate as 1, number of kernels are 64. Try to compute second convolutional layer. Convolutional layer means you need to apply this kernel 3x3 on the input of 26x26x32. On this, you need to apply. Resultant of my convolutional layer 1, that is output of convolutional layer 1, will become input to convolutional layer 2. Okay, that is why I asked you to consider input for convolutional layer 2 is as 26 cross 26 cross 32. And make this change as well. Number of kernels that we are computing for this layer is 32. Whereas for this second one is 64 only. I hope all of you know how do we have achieved this 32, 320. Okay, it is simply the size of the kernel 3 cross 3 cross 1 plus 1 bias value I am going to add to each of my kernel. Here I have this kernel size as 3 cross 3, so 3 cross 3 cross 1 plus 1 as bias multiplied by 64. Not 64, 32. I have taken 32, right? So it is 320. Okay, now you apply for this input image, apply convolutional operation with this kernel size, try it as 1 and number of kernels as 64, and try to get the output as well as number of parameters. Okay, correct. 24 cross 24 cross 64. Here depth will be 64 because simply check number of kernels that we are applying on this particular input, that is 26 cross 26, right? So it comes out to be 24 cross 24 cross 64 as my output of convolutional operation. Okay, right. So number of parameters will be 3 cross 3 cross 32, right, plus 1 in multiplied by 64. So it comes out to be 18496, right? Okay. This is my output of my convolutional layer. Now the output of convolutional layer will be will act as an input to my next layer. My next layer is maximum pooling layer, max pool layer. Okay, so for max pool layer, input size is 24 cross 24 cross 64, and for every 2 cross 2 block I will select the maximum value. What should be the output volume and resultant number of parameters which are required? Compute. We know when we apply max pool layer on the given image, okay, depth will remain same as the input image, that is 64. Only thing is that which is going to reduce is my dimension, height and width. Okay, so it will reduce by half, 12 cross 12 cross 12 into 64, because my depth will remain same as the input and number of parameter is 0. Okay, Yes, number of parameters which are required to learn is 0. Now we will have fully connected layer, okay, that is dense layer with 128 neurons in that particular layer. Now compute the output units. Total number of output units in full when we perform fully connected connected layer, as well as number of parameters. Fully connected layer, you remember, it is same as feed forward, the hidden layers or output layer that we are considering in case of fully connected layer, feed forward neural network, right? Let me take one example and later on I will give you some time. Here, output which it has produced, maximum pooling layer has produced, is 12 × 12 × 64. So all these output volume, the output volume will be converted to one vector of length this, of size this much, okay? And 12 × 12 × 64 you can compute, and it will result into some vector, and that particular vector will be connected with, fully connected with 128 neurons of fully connected layer. Okay. So 12 × 12 × 64 multiplied by 128 plus 128 will become number of parameters. Right. So output unit is 128. We all know at the output we are having 128 neurons, hence 128 neurons. But number of parameters for the connections between this layer and this layer will be these many. Okay. Now, one fully connection connected layer, okay, fully connected layer will be connected with second fully connected layer with 10 neurons. Okay. Now compute number of parameters. No. In the first fully connected layer one, no. See, in the first, let me explain. In a fully connected layer one, we have how many neurons? We have 128 neurons. Yes, it is correct. 128 neurons. In the second fully connected layer, we do have 10 neurons, and we have seen in feed forward neural network how dense connections will perform. Yes, yes. 128 into 10 plus 10 bias to each of those 10 neurons. So it comes out to be 1290. Right? Total parameters for the given architecture which need to be learned are these many. Okay? Starting from input image till the output image. Okay? These parameters need to be learned using backpropagation algorithm, right? So like this, given any architecture, any sort of architecture, one should be able to, you all should be able to compute the number of parameters and as well as output volume after performing convolutional operation, max pooling, as well as fully connected layer. Okay, so now, the same thing when we perform the coding, okay, with the, for the same example, I have created this simple model with first as 32 kernels, next fully convolutional layer 64, and later on applied max pooling with pool size as 2x2. And then we are flattening. Why we are using flattening? Because this need to be done now. 12x12x64 need to be done or need to be converted to one vector. Okay. That vector size will be 12x12x64. Right. So for that sake, I'm going to perform flattening of the result of max pooling will need to be flattened. So that will be provided as an input to my next layer, that is fully connected layer with 128 neurons. And afterwards, we do have one more neuron. We have added one more dense connection that with 10 neurons. Fine. With this, when we perform model.summary, when we perform this particular function, we are going to get output shape as well as parameters. Okay, so one should know first theoretically how we are going to achieve given any architecture with input image, size of input image and size of the number of kernels and size of the kernel, what is the result of my output. Okay, that should be clear to you. Even you can cross-check with this particular function. For the given architecture, it comes out to be same as whatever we have computed manually, total number of parameters. With respect to each layer also, first we have performed one convolutional layer and next convolution layer, two convolutional layer, one after the other. And later on, we performed max pooling layer and we have flattened it because we need to perform some sort of fully connected layers. So this result of max pooling, we have flattened, and this flattening results in 9216, 1, that is one vector will be provided to me, and later on this 9216 will be connected with 128 neurons in first fully connected neuron and network, and this particular fully connected layer will be densely connected again with 10 neurons. Okay, like this I have two convolutional layer, I have one max pooling layer, and I have two fully connected layers. Okay, with these, I need to, for this particular given architecture, total number of parameters that need to be learned are these many. Right. So next class, we are going to see some of the architectures which have been proposed by researchers. Okay, we will pick one or two and we will discuss the detailed architecture. Fine. And maybe in the next class, that is on Friday, you will see the implementation part, like how do we import the standard architecture in our program. These are the different references that I have used for today's class. With this, I will stop. Sakshi? I'm ready to take your queries now.
Hello?
Yes.
I have two questions. First one is about the padding for the convolution. Padding for the convolution. When you were doing that, when you were writing on the board, the formula was minus twice the padding, but that should be plus, right?
No, it should be minus only.
So with padding, the size decreases. It should increase.
Yeah, it should. It will remain same. Same as my input image.
So it needs to be plus, not minus. If you go back in the presentation, you have the sketch.
Okay. There. Okay. Fine. If you can go for plus. You can add it.
Yeah. So that was my first question. The second one is for the slides. Is it possible to get a copy of the slides? Because it's much better for us. This has been said even by other students.
I will discuss with Sakshi and I will let you know. Okay?
Okay.
I haven't discussed with that.
Thank you very much.
Welcome. Any other query?
मैम सेकंड कन्वोल्यूशनल लेयर वाला बताने के बाद दोबारा
सेकंड कन्वोल्यूशनल लेयर ओके लेट मी शेयर द स्क्रीन अगेन ओके दिस वन
यस मैम
ओके सो हियर what we have so here what we have we do have convolutional layer 1 okay this is the resultant of convolutional layer 1 26 × 26 × 32 so you got number of parameters as 320 correct and kernel size is 3 × 3 fine now I want to apply second convolutional operation with this kernel size. Okay, what is the resultant of output volume? Resultant of output volume should be this 26 minus 3 comes out to be 23. Okay, minus that 2 into p divided by s plus 1, so it comes out to be 24. So height width will be 24 × 24 and depth is 64. Why depth is 64? Because we are applying 64 kernels. So depth of my convolution operation will be 64. And number of parameters, how do I compute number of parameters? It is computed with kernel size 3 × 3 × this time. What is the size of my like depth of my kernel? Depth of my kernel should be, I said, same as my input image here 32. 32 plus 1. This whole multiplied by how many kernels that we are using? 64 kernels we are using. So 64, it comes out to be 18496. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Once it is clear, then it's easier for the coming classes. How do we compute like number of parameters and number of what is the output volume for any given layer? Right. Any other query?
Yeah, about the number of parameters being learned. I did not get that. Why it's zero?
For cooling layer.
Yeah. Okay. Why it was calculated to be zero?
Okay, because as such in cooling, using cooling layer, we are not performing any kind of computations with respect to input. Okay. Only one whatever value maximum value in that 2 × 2 max pool. We are extracting that value, then no need to learn, right? And we are not performing the kernel convolution operation. Whereas in the convolution operation, we are performing that convolution. If I take 3 × 3, we do have some weights. Let's take 101, 101 and −1, −1, −1. Okay, that operation, that convolution, we are going to perform on the input image. Corresponding multiplication I will do on for all 9 cells and later on I will add them all. Okay, so it gives me 1 pixel, right? So here we are performing some sort of computations, whereas in max pooling we are not performing any kind of computations. We are only extracting the the highest value in max pool, in the max pool of block 2 × 2. No, we are not performing any kernel computations. Hence, no need to learn anything in the max pool. So in convolution neural network, minimum number of parameters in any of the given architecture will be zero if we use max pool, and maximum number of parameters which need to be learned will be at the dash layer. Can anyone answer this? Highest number of parameters that need to be learned in which layer of convolutional neural network?
I guess the first layer, I guess.
Which layer?
The first one.
It should be fully connected layer, the last layers. Okay, because their connections are very dense as compared to the convolutional layer. Because max pooling layer, there is, we are, as such, no connections are there. Only we are extracting the high values from the given input image. Okay, so no parameters need to be learned. Highest number of parameters in convolutional operation are usually in the fully connected layer. And in convolutional operation, we have already seen how do we compute number of parameters, right? Is there any doubt? Okay. With this, Sakshi, we can end the session here.
Okay, ma'am. If there are no doubts, then we can end the session. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you
everyone. So I have pasted the attendance link in the chat window. Kindly copy it and submit your attendance within next 10 minutes. Otherwise, that link will be disabled after that. Thank you.